before I proceed to showing you my little journey on the 75-gallon INT, the whole scape process from A to Z, I kind of wanted to explain as to why I made my scape in this tank similar to the one in my next tank. I basically copied the same type of design where I have something very complex on one side and then a very, very minimalistic aquascape on the other, leaving a lot of room for negative space, yet at the same time achieving lots of room for random flow to go underneath the scape and lots of places for fish to hide. My scape has lots of undersides that have like caves and everything. You can see my scape is technically, let me move this thing out of the way. My scape is actually not touching the back wall, so that allows for water to flow in and throughout the whole thing. Another thing I have in mind when I'm creating a scape is what's going to be aesthetically pleasing for that type of tank. For this tank, in my situation, I knew that I had a lot of room to play with front and back, so when I made this, I made it on a table, by the way, just with the drawn out square of the dimensions that I have here. I wanted things to stick out at you and kind of give you the appearance that what you're looking at in the front also has a lot of stuff in the background, so it almost gives you like a field of depth to where you think, man, there's something way back there that makes the tank look so huge. So, as you can see again, a lot of negative space, something very complex on the other side, which is exactly what I planned on doing with my 75-gallon reef tank. I just personally enjoy this type of formula for aquascaping in my own preference. I basically just pieced together some of my favorite reefs, so if I were you guys, I would take the time to study some other aquascapes that you really enjoy to look at, and do your best to either replicate that or maybe combine the two of your favorite scapes and apply them to the tank that you're designing currently. Because guys, I tell you, you're going to have to stare at the scape all the time, and it really paid off for me in my case with this 25 Lagoon here. I'm still satisfied with the scape, and it gave me a lot of room and opportunity for corals to grow, so always keep those things in mind. So my hopes after all this being said is that you guys really put some thought and creativity into the scape that you're designing for your tank here. Alright guys, so let's proceed on to the rest of the aquascape video. So what you're looking at here is the left side of my scape. It's going to be a very minimalistic piece. It's just going to be shaped kind of like a Y. I drilled these two holes you see right here, basically to add extra support. That little barb is actually a piece of a fishing pole. This is actually my second attempt of having this piece glued. So I'm going to be mixing in the solution that came with the eMarco cement. Kind of give you an idea generally of like how the consistency of the product should look. Alright, so that cement is holding up pretty well. I feel like the left side of the scape is near to completion, although I felt like maybe it was missing one piece. So I'm gonna keep playing around with my options here, and basically try to add another piece of tonga sticking out towards the glass, and also at the same time make the appearance look somewhat natural. Actually gonna do that little spot right there. Almost like a tack weld.
Right.
Use some super glue. And I'm gonna use this instant hardening gel. Too is if I want these pieces to overhang and I want them to actually stay put, I have to make sure that there's a lot of contact room so that way the cement can really seal and have like a really good hold. You can see that there's plenty of room for me just to put all kinds of cement in there, get it started. To hold this portion of the scape up, I'm going to be using
these cups I bought. So it just stands like that. I'm pretty impatient too, so I like to blow dry it. It kind of gets it to harden up quicker. Oh, and I put it on heat, by the way. So I'm getting super excited here. I love the way that this just molds and flows together. It almost looks like it's not four or five pieces glued together. I have a little bit of an issue though. This rock right here, this piece is just annoying and it's obnoxious and it's gonna hit the back wall. So we're gonna attempt to just break it off. I'm gonna show you guys a way to break it off really easily and without ruining the whole scape. So what I'm doing right now is kind of holding the tonga with my legs closed, just so the vibrations don't go throughout the tonga and break the rest of it. I really just wanna break the end of it. So just one quick tap and hold it really tight. Oh my, that's perfect. Yes. Test fit. Oh, I love that.
Yeah.
I love it. This is gonna have a lot of swim through and just areas for fish to hide. I really wanted this part of the scape to be a little higher, so I'm gonna try to utilize some more tonga and make something a little higher right here. So here we are again with my favorite Dollar Tree glue, Super Glue Gel. This type specifically along with Bob Smith Industries Instaset Solution. If you're lucky enough to come across some real branch rock like this, you're going to find that most of the pieces are going to be broken up. So what I like to do is grab multiple pieces and piece them together and try to create some type of natural flow. So for example, I put these two random rocks together and it almost gave it a natural appearance. Here you can see I'm gluing another part of the scape. I'm going to attempt to put this arm and hang it up there like this.
So here it is, it's starting to come alive. It's gonna have a lot of room for some lower light corals right there, some SPS right here, maybe some euphilia in the back to kind of give it some more personality. Kind of debating right here if I should leave it open, have some shadows and just some dark areas down here. This is gonna be my next possible piece to add to the scape. Don't know if I like it. It's a little too much going on right there, but I don't know. I think I'm just gonna leave it without it for now. So the scape stands about 13 inches tall. Yeah, just about 13 inches tall in the back. The tank is 20 inches tall. I wanted this part to be a lot higher than this part right here, for sure. So here we are, I'm about to glue this little arm up here. See, I'm utilizing the cups, holding it up there. Check out that glue and cement I put on there. Holding up pretty well. This is gonna be where I'm gluing.
Finally, all those hours of hard work has paid off. Now it's time for me to take this scape from my cousin's garage down the street and just walk it over to my house. Hopefully I don't break it.
This thing's pretty heavy.
Alright guys, so I went ahead and put some sand in there to kind of give you an idea what it'll look like. Oh man, this is scary. Alright. There we go. First part. Look at that. Sweet. Now, I'm gonna put this guy in there. On the left side. Well guys, there you have it. This is the end result of my 75-gallon Nuvo INT series build from Innovative Marine. I hope it inspired you a little bit to put some more effort in your next aquascape, or maybe even rearrange the current aquascape you have now. If you guys enjoyed this video, please do me a favor, give me a thumbs up, and also hit that subscribe button for more future updates on this build. As always, happy reefing. See you later, guys.